Welcome to another one of our videos learning how to use the SPSS program to complete some of the statistics you'll be required to complete for this class. This video is on correlations. So what I'm going to do first is I already have downloaded all of my data and information that I need to complete the laboratory assignment. I'm going to go ahead and open our software. I'm using the Virtual Owl software again, which allows me to remote in. If you're having any difficulty with this, remember that you can use all of the computer labs on campus to do the same thing. Here I am at the first menu. I'm going to click More Files. I'm going to find where I have downloaded my specific files. And I'm going to select some random data. This is very different data than the one that you're using for the lab this week. But it will allow me to show you how to do two important things, and that is to run a correlation. And it will allow me to show you how to get frequencies and descriptives on a new variable that you will complete, which is a total score. So I'm going to go ahead and go into my variable view and see. Make sure all of my typing is correct, but all of my measure is unknown for this particular lab, so I'm going to take a minute and get those worked out. All right, now that all of my variable measurement type has been changed to be appropriate, I'm going to start by showing you how to calculate a new variable that this data came from a survey. And I have a column here for each one of the survey items, and instead what I need is a total score. What I'm going to do is go up to Compute Variable, and this menu is going to allow me to do all sorts of wonderful, useful things with my already existing data. I can add certain pieces of information together, I can multiply it, divide it, and do almost any kind of mathematical calculation I need to make an entirely new variable. For example, let's say I was interested in making a total score for this measure. I would need to name the target variable, which is the new variable you're creating, something useful, something that where I could pick it out and understand what I was working with. For this example, I'm going to literally name it total score. And then in this numeric expression box, notice there's an equal sign right here between your target variable and this box. What that means is that anything that you put in that box is what is going to make up this new variable that you created. So let's say, for example, I wanted it to add all of these items together. Well, all you need to do to make it add is move one variable over, click the plus button, and then click the next variable over, and on until you get all the variables that you want to be added together. All right, now that I have all the variables added together, I'm going to click OK. And our output window is going to tell me that it has accomplished that. So we're going to go back to our data set and scroll over, and there is our brand new total score variable. I need to go ahead and double check. Has it been numeric and scale? Yes, it has. Fantastic. Again, I can do anything I want to with this compute a variable menu. If I wanted my total score to be multiplied by 2, I could take a new thing, make a new variable, have it say total score 2, get rid of all of that information, and come over here, move total score, multiply 2. And there, as you can see, the new variable just multiplies this column by 2. Let's say I wanted to make a subscale with studying behaviors, studying subscale. So for this, maybe I'd like to see how much time someone spends in quiet study versus, and add that to how many times they study once at least a week, plus changes in their study habits. Okay, so I'm going to take these four variables, and I'm going to say that that makes a studying subscale. For your lab, you are going to have to look at what are certain subscales, what questions go with that subscale, and adding those together. So here we go, and there's our studying subscale. All right. All right, so now we have two new subscales and a total score that didn't exist with the data file that I was given. Now we're going to learn how to run a correlation. This, we're going to go up to Analyze, go down to Correlate. That at least should make sense. But what we want is a bivariate correlate. So this is our bivariate correlation menu. Again, as most of the menus with SPSS, all I need to do is take something from the left and move it over to the right if the program is supposed to run the test on those particular variables. For this first one, I'm going to take the studying subscale and see if it correlates with the class time subscale. The first box asks you which type of correlation you're running. For this class, you're going to need to be able to decide between a Pearson's correlation and a Spearman's row. I would review the textbook and the lecture if you do not know the difference between these two tests. Also, I can change whether or not I'm looking for a two-tailed or a one-tailed test. For this first lab, I want you to run a two-tailed test on everything. As we move through the semester and you learn a little bit more about what it takes to be a two-tailed test versus a one-tailed test and how that relates to hypotheses, you may be changing this box. Also, you want to make sure you keep the box that says flag significant correlations checked. This is going to put a little asterisk by the correlations that are statistically significant. If we needed to, we could also go up here to the options to change out some of the options, but it's not necessary for this lab. So I'm going to click OK. And then here in my output window, I'm going to see what the results are. If I had wanted to, I can actually add lots of things into the correlation menu. Let's say I wanted to run a Spearman's row correlation on some of this other data. I can select several things, move them over, and now you can see what a correlation table looks like when you are using multiple correlations. You can go for each column or each row, it's going to take the variables you've selected and correlate it with one other thing. Correlation is always between two things, particularly in a bivariate correlation. So if I wanted to see if making a to-do list is correlated with reading carefully, I would come over here. So far you have learned how to calculate a new variable by making use of the compute variable option, and you've also learned how to run both types of correlations under the bivariate correlation menu. The only other thing we might want to do is to run descriptive statistics, particularly frequencies, on these new variables we have calculated. So I can come over here, and just like we did in the previous lab, I can add all kinds of information to the frequency chart and then run that on our new computed variables. Let's say I wanted to know how many people had a total score of 0 to 50 on this measure. Well, I could come over here and see that the lowest number is 41, and so between 41 and 50, this many people actually came up with that score, so I can actually add those together. Fortunately, that's a small number, and I can add that in my head if I needed to. But I could also come over here to the cumulative percent and see what percent that is of my total. And it's 19.6% of my sample scored between 0 and 50 points on the total score. So again, I'm going to make sure that I save this data somewhere I can find it again if I needed to. And then I can close down this program and Virtual Owl and move on. All right? Let me know if you have any questions, and I'll see you next time.